many of them is here? Let me tell you, if they were here, they would succeed. Put me anywhere. One minute, I went to school. I've been to the best of schools. I've been to Oxford. I've been to Cambridge. I've been to all of them. And I tell you what, have you ever seen anybody in this country who walked into the bank and was given money based on intellectual capital? They will tell you to bring your grandmother's house, your father's old house, your grand. By the time you finish it, that's it. Bill Gates was given $1 million. Go and read the history of Microsoft by a bank. For a young boy who was in a garage. Steve Jobs and his friend Wozniak was given $2 million. Who would have given them that type of money here? Nobody. Let me tell you, Steve Jobs went and brought John Scully. John Scully was the CEO of Pepsi. Steve Jobs sent him a text and continued to send him a text. Do you want to continue selling sugared water or do you want to be part of changing the world? One day, John Scully got up and said to Pepsi, where is president and CEO? I'm leaving this company. I want to go and join these small boys in a garage. Which person will do it here? His people will say that they don't do a mess, no. Nobody will do it. That's what we have. The government will not support you. You do anything here, the government will not patronize you. They will not patronize white man. They will not do it. So there's so many things we take against. That is where a journalist has to say, let us take it back. Let nobody tell you there's not enough money. No. Tell me what a governor in Nigeria needs a dispatch rider for. What for? If I tell you how we stop fuel, we used to have a fuel dump when I was governor. Fuel dump. It was costing us almost 30 million a month. I said, what is it? They say, hey. I said, shut it down. I found out that my convoy in the first 2 weeks, because it was about 22 vehicles, was costing us about 300,000 to buy fuel. Of course, you know what happens to half of it. So I said, okay, you know what we're going to do? Bring down the convoy. People in Anambra here, I don't use sir. I asked them, carry this in and go. Pack it. My convoy is 5 vehicles. And you cannot buy fuel unless I'm inside the car. So I will pay them. No more. People will say, hey, wait a minute. I'm telling the youths that are here, it is your future that they are toying with. I have children. I have kids. I have 2 lovely children that are graduates. Somebody told me just yesterday, he said to me, my friend Chida, we were going somewhere, and I was telling him about the text my daughter sent to me. I wish I read that type of text to you and you will understand. And somebody said to me, oh, I saw your son going to, that one was in Vietnam. He was going to run somewhere. He said he's going for interview for job. Peter, can't you give him a job? Peter, can't you do this? The boy doesn't even have, I said, none of my children have car. I was the only person who is governor and bank chairman, not to them. Nobody elected them one. They have to look for a job. They have to do what they need to do. Take back your country. This country belongs to you. It is your future that they are toying with. You must take it back from them. It is not your country. And you must take it back from them. And how will you take it back from them? How will you take it back from them? When they invite you, go to your local government and ask the local government chairman who receives 100 million naira every month. What does he do with it? He will tell you no problem. Yes, he's buying new Jeep. This is somebody who has never seen car in his life. He now uses Jeep. His wife has become first lady of the local government. You go everywhere, a convoy will pass you. They say it's first lady of the state. First what? This man, this woman is like they used to tell me then, hey, Peter, you're not treating your wife fairly. Peter, you're not doing this. That this is this. I said, no. There's so many costs. If I tell you little, if I have time and tell you cost of governance here, you won't be here. When I came back, when I started, we had about 10 governors' guest house. I said, what is governor going to do with this? I go to work in the morning, I go back in the evening. I'll come back. My cook then will cook about food that about 50 people will eat. I said, what is this for? They were killing one cow every day. I said, what is this for? He said, Your Excellency, I'm doing it in case if you come back with people. I said, have you ever seen me come back here with anybody? So why are you cooking for the people? Any day people will come here, I will let you know. Cook for only one person. One person. Me. I said, don't do it. You know, I come from Anambra State. There's too many big men. Of course. Like I told them, I said, don't allow any of them to come here. I don't have what it takes to entertain them. So what they do, they phone me, Peter, I want to see you. I come to your house in the evening. So I go to his house, because there he will bring his champagne, eat his fabulous food, and at times when I'm going, they will give me some to take back. Goodbye. But don't go to government house. Because government house is not a restaurant. It's not a place to drink champagne. A bottle of champagne today costs about 400,000, 500,000. That is salary of 20 people at 20,000. And you drink it with the public money. No, you can't do that. If you want to do that, you go to your house. So I said to them, no, this is government money. We brought down the cost of feeding governor. If I tell you where I brought it down from, to this, I say, this will be enough. Don't worry about me. And I can go on and on. You can go and work with people. It's not anything. It's not any magic. I fly, every flight I've taken in Nigeria as a governor was economy. Reason is simple. If I come, they say, business class, 54,000. Other one, you go to the internet, it's 19,000. Is it not just from Abuja to this for 40 minutes? Why will I pay additional 1,000? I said, no. I went to Young Shagura and said, your hotel in Abuja, can you give me this card? He gave me 50%. So to sleep there is 30,000 naira. And I said, no. That is what people want me to go to another bigger hotel and stay for 250,000 naira. And people say, oh, Peter, is it? I said, well, I have a problem. If I sleep there and pay somebody 250, I will be awake. I wouldn't be asleep. Because I think they've stolen my money. Because I would think they have stolen my money. So it is important that you understand our government, we need to shut down cost of governance. No state government needs a house in Abuja. The governor doesn't live in Abuja. They don't need all this. Nobody wants to kill you. I was governor for 8 years without a bulletproof car. I must tell you that I bought one, but I didn't use it, and nobody killed me. I was using Prado. They will say, hey, it's not balance, it's not this. Another thing they keep telling me, that government vehicles, because of high traffic, is every 6 months. I say, wait, if you remove this car from here, because you know what they do, they take it into auction and sell. I say, no, this car is here for the term. We will use it. It's functional. What do people think you're doing to yourself? We must shut down. And people say, where did you get money? To say, where did you get money? We got those monies. We were owing gratuities and pension of people for 35 billion. We were able to pay it. Because we have to shut down everything. I said, this cannot happen. Nobody will ever tell you that you came to a party while I was governor for 8 years. It's not a party, it's not a nightclub. No, it's governor's lodge. When I finish, I go home. If anybody wants to dance, he goes to that club. That is his business. And so all I'm trying to say is that we can change no visitor. We put in a hotel if you have any value to offer. And go and check. We are number one in implementation of MDG. We got an award for it. I spoke at the UN. Go to European Union. We are number one in European Union while I was there. Why am I saying this? We were able to meet up every obligation. So my dear people, yes, it's good to stay here and feel bad and do everything, but let me beg you, you have no other country except this one. And only you can do this. If anybody is telling you, those people out there, they don't know you. They don't care about you. If they care, they will do things differently. You will see it in their behavior. You will see it in the way they do things, the way they feel, the way they move, and everything. And that, because they are doing that, what I beg you is that you must, like Olisa pleaded, get up and decide to join politics. Get up and decide to be part of it. The man who is leading revolution in Hong Kong is 17 years old. He's 17 years old. My dear people, the society we help them to abuse today will take his revenge on all of us tomorrow. Thank you and God bless you.